I keep getting asked, what is this machine that we see behind you? And I figure I'd take a few minutes to show you it, and you'll find it very interesting. It's a coil winding machine for making transformers. It's used to take a 12-volt input and step it up to 120 volts AC. A transformer starts its life as a bobbin. This is what's known as a bobbin. And all it is a plastic core that allows you to wind wire around it. You can see that this is basically a lathe with a wire wrapping tool on the front of it. So we have our wire here that's going to be pulled through and then wrapped onto our core once I put it on the machine. Right now I'm going to wrap the primary 10 times. The machine is programmed to do so, so all I have to do is hit start. And there's our primary wrapped 10 times. So we're just going to attach the second part of the loop to the second contact. So there's the primary. There we go. Now that we've finished winding our transformer, let's go solder it. So the next step is, because we have a primary on two wires and a secondary on the other two, we need to solder them for a good connection. So we're going to wrap it tightly around each post. I usually use hemostats to do that. And now for our last step, we're going to solder the wires to the bobbin pins. This is a special transformer wire that's designed to melt automatically the coating when you use solder. So we just have to get a nice ball on it, heat it up, and it solders itself. And one more. The next step takes a little while to dry. What we're going to do is dip each transformer in varnish. Just standard varnish available at your local home store. And we do this just to secure the transformer windings, because believe it or not, they do tend to vibrate when a signal goes through them. So this helps reduce that. I won't be able to show you the final assembly because we have to wait for the varnish to dry. So on this unfinished one, I'll show you what we're going to do once it dries. We take this ferrite core and slide it over our bobbin. We will then super glue the bottom half to it like this. And this will be our final transformer. We'll wrap some tape around it, and it'll wind up looking like this when it's completed.